some of that glass cooktop clean. Clean off the stove here. So you see the stove here is a little dirty. That was from last night and night before last. Just sit, come up here, clean it real quick. Why not make a video while I'm doing it? So, just put that all around. Get up with the sponge. A little scrubber here. Just throw it on there real quick. I normally just flip it over. Ah, there you go. Flip it over like that. Start a new side. And get clean napkins. And just wipe off. Now I can really concentrate on the spots I need to, like right here. If you guys, you can't see it, but it's a ring around here. Let me show it so you can see it. Need to concentrate on this and just the back a little bit, if you can see that. So those are my main spots right now to concentrate on. Okay, that's a good angle. Those are my main spots. This, definitely. This, and this. So what I'm gonna do now is make sure I got it wiped up good. And apply more wax around here, and just a dab over here. You want to shake it up to clean it. Use this razor. Let me see, can you guys see it? There you go. So I use this razor. Okay, you see it now. And it's just got a little actual, let me see, has a razor on the tip. You can buy the kit at Walmart over there toward the Ziploc bags at clean supplies and stuff, chemicals. You buy it at Walmart for like 10 bucks. Comes with this, comes with that brush, and it comes with a small thing of wax to start with. I bought the bigger one later. So, I'm just gonna go around the rings and really get some cleaning done. And if you can see, that's the dirt already coming off there. Thank you. I normally wipe it in a pattern, like everything over here, and then go from there. See, look at that. That's already like 10 times better. As you wipe, it's gonna get like a slippery surface, so it's like a buff. Okay, so I'm just gonna bring it down here. And you see how it's just powdered up? Yeah, you definitely don't wanna just push that all on the floor. Especially us right now, cause our dog's out. And 9 times out of 10, I guarantee they eat it. It's no when or if they're gonna eat it. And I'm not worried about getting it spotless because I'm going over it one more time lightly with wax. So, if you can see, that is, you can't see it, that's all the powder, all the dry wax. And that's all it is, honestly, guys. It's just wax. It's you're buffing your stove. Basically, all you're doing. The slippery, you keep your stove. So I'm just holding my hand at the edge. If you can see it, I'm just holding my hand at the edge. But the slippery, you keep your stove. The better off it's gonna be. If you keep it wax, a good wax on it, the easier it's gonna be to clean. If you go a long period of time without putting anything on it, it's gonna be hard to clean. And see, we got an in-between cleaner too I'd like to show you. Just a cooktop spray. So, like when we get done cooking in between, we just spray that on and we're good to go. We wait till the stove cools, of course. And then spray that on as an in-between cleaner to somewhat keep it clean in between the cooking times for me, you know, doing this. Because this is the actual deep cleaner. You don't do this until it's really dirty. This is not a daily, or for me, it's not a daily nor weekly maintenance. I do this once a month. So once a month, I do this. And it works out well. Okay, look. Got the good wax on the stove. I'm just buffing it out real good this one last time. Okay. Clean paper towels. Always go back clean. And now I can go in a circular motion. Now this is the deep clean. I'm buffing it. After this, I'm done. So I want to get every little bit of wax I can get. So that is the actual stove cleaning. Look at that. That is the stove cleaning. And that's it, guys. You guys have a good holiday.